Hello. Hope you all are doing good during this lockdown. My name is Aastha Malu. I'm the founder of Pattern Studio. We are based in Mumbai. We design and develop customized ceramic and glass products. But today, it's not about ceramic, it's not about glass. I'm going to demonstrate some fun techniques to make some fun souvenirs using this atta clay. The recipe is very simple. We just need four ingredients, which is atta, namak, tel, pani, water, salt, vegetable oil and flour, which is easily available in any kitchen. We'll be making pencil accessories, fridge magnets. Once they are dried and hard, we can paint them with beautiful patterns using acrylic colors. Isn't that exciting? Let's get started. To make these fun souvenirs with atta clay, you need atta. The atta should be quite soft and moldable. So just check the consistency if it's soft enough to work with. We need a fork, pen cap, a toothpick, a roller, some grains and spices to decorate the pieces, some vegetable oil, and acrylic color bottle. Let's start with applying some oil on our palms. By doing so, the atta clay won't stick to our palms or fingertips. Now I will take some clay in my hands and will cross check if it's sticking to my fingertips or palm. If it's not, we are ready to start with the first object. The first one which we are making is a snail. So I will roll the coil, and while rolling, I'm making sure the entire palm is being used from fingertip to the end of my palm. I'm rolling it very softly and gently. While I'm rolling it, the coil is getting thinner and longer. So I need to be even more careful while rolling it further. Did you notice it's a rhythmic motion, to and fro, to and fro? Check if there are any cracks or not. If there are no cracks, hooray, we can proceed. Once our coil is long enough and thin enough, we will start rolling it into a snail. I will start with taking one of the ends of the coil and simply start rotating it into a spiral or a jalebi form. We will keep rotating the piece until we reach the other end of the coil. The other end will be an open end, and we will make the face with it. I am pinching and pressing the back of the snail so we can make a tail out of it. Our basic form is ready. Now we can add eyes. I will just make two holes with the toothpick and add some mustard seeds to make the eye. While lifting the snail or handling it, be very gentle because the clay is still very soft and it can deform very easily. Yay! Our snail is ready. Let's keep the snail aside, and until it dries, we can make our next piece, which is an owl. Do you know an owl can only see in the dark at night? We will repeat the process of greasing our hands with oil, and once that is done, we will take some clay and press it into a ball. Once our atta clay ball is ready, we will press it between our hands to make a flat shape. Once that is done, I will take the roller and roll it further. It doesn't need to be a circle or an oval, it can be an organic form. Once our slab is thin and big enough, we will stop rolling. Now I am taking a baby spoon to make feather textures of the owl. From the mid of the slab till the bottom of the slab. Very carefully, I'm just making some impressions. Please make sure that the slab doesn't get torn. Don't press the spoon very hard. Once the textures are ready, I'm keeping the spoon aside. The next step is to fold the slab. I am folding the right side like a flap. And now I am folding the left side and making sure they both are joining or meeting in the center of the slab. I am folding it from the top which is overlapping the right and the left flaps. By pinching one of the corners of the top flap, I am making the ears of the owl. We don't need to add any extra clay. With the help of the cap, I will make impressions for the eyes. The eyes are very big, but we can always add small holes, the cornea, with the help of toothpick. So our owl is almost ready. I'm just adding two mustard seeds as the eyes of the owl. Very carefully I'm keeping the owl aside so we can work on the next piece, which is a beautiful fish. We will repeat the process by greasing our hands, by applying some oil, by taking some clay and rolling it into a slab. But this time we need a circular thin slab. So with the help of the roller, I am rolling it very thin. Now I am taking a circular metal bowl to cut it into a circular slab. I will start by placing the bowl upside down on the slab. I will make sure there is enough slab on all the sides of the circular bowl. I am pressing the bowl slightly to make very slight impression and cutting it through and through. The extra clay around the bowl, I will reuse it in the next piece. Our circular slab is ready. We will start by folding the circular slab into a semicircle and pressing it thoroughly from all the sides. Now we will fold it further and pressing it again. With the help of a toothpick, I will make four sections on the circular arc. Now I will add textures with the help of the fork on both the sides and these will become our fins. Once we are done with the textures, I will pinch these four parts into pointed tail and fins very gently and softly. As the clay is soft and our slab was quite thin, cap of acrylic bottle, I am adding a circular mouth to the fish on both the sides. Now I am adding some scales on both the sides with the help of the pen cap. To separate the face and the fish tail, I am slightly pressing it with a toothpick over here, which will prominently define the face of our fish. We'll repeat the process on the other side as well by turning that straight line into a curved outline of the face. Flip the fish and check if it's properly done on the other side as well, taking pinch of the clay and making the eyes of the fish. And also adding two mustard seeds to make the eyes. Our fish is ready, but to add little detail, I am making an open mouth of the fish. I am keeping it aside so we can work on our next piece, which is an interesting pencil holder. This time I'm taking a big chunk of Arta clay, making an oval shape and pressing it from one of the sides so our pencil holder can balance well on the surface of our table. Pinching one of the sides of the oval shaped dough into a nosy mouth and keeping the other side fat and round. Before we start poking with the help of a pencil, let's grease the nib of the pencil with oil so that the clay doesn't stick on the nib. Count the number of color pencils or color crayons you have and make that many holes in your pencil holder. On the pointed end of this holder, I am adding two eyes. Our pencil holder is ready. Next object, which is a small pencil accessory. It's a small one but very tricky one, so please follow step very carefully. With the clay, I am making a small coil. Putting it into a U form, keeping both the open ends toward myself, I am placing a pencil on top of our U-formed coil and putting both the open ends to make a loop. I am repeating the process very slowly. So, taking the open ends and putting it to make a loop. We can easily remove the pencil and push it back. Until the piece dries, I will suggest you to keep the pencil inside the loop itself so we can retain the form. Both the open ends are the ears of a bunny. Adding some details with the help of toothpick. Now I am making two eyes with the help of tooth dal. No doubt it was tricky but fun too to make a bunny pencil accessory out of coil. So wasn't it fun? Hope you all had great time making these cute, quirky and beautiful objects using Arta clay. Please follow World Art Community and Pattern Studio on Instagram, Facebook and also share your comments, photos and experiences with us. Thank you.